Hello, world. Hello, people. Excuse my hair because my hair is a mess. I am done with my shoot. It was just a cough, okay? Ain't no illness here. But I'm done with today's shoots. Shoot, because I had one customer. This corona sickness thing, even though it's not in this area at all, people are going crazy about that. But I had a customer today. And I wanted to do a little full moon reading. It is cold, so that's why I have the blanket on. And yeah, my hair is absolutely a mess. That's why I use my lovely wigs these days, because that I haven't had the time to color it yet. But yeah, I just had a nappy because I was so tired after the shoot. I have my medical crystals here that I was sleeping with. But let's do this magical reading. I did actually already post a full moon video if you guys haven't seen it. Oh, hello, sunshine. I will link it up here somewhere so you guys can see it if you haven't seen it yet. But I just wanted to come on here and just, you know, do a little extra. Because we all like that. So this is a cozy full moon reading with these lovely magical cards that are matching. But I hope you guys are doing good. I am, even though that my energy is very low. I think it's just like, you know, I've been so hyper all day, the past days, that, you know, and I have glitter everywhere again because the customer I had wanted to have glitter, so the glitter is back. I did go into details about what this full moon is about in the other video I did. So I'm not going to go into that much details, but I guess I'm still going to talk about it a little bit. Because a lot of you guys, you know, there's two things that's going to happen that might already have happened the past days. But either you're going to be, you know, like very emotional, like the universe or your angels or guides are going to force you into healing things, or you're going to be super motivated and having this power of doing new things all the time. And I have had that for the past days, like with the witchiness, that I want to be more witchy on my channel. Still doing tarot cards because, you know, it's what I do, but also focus on other things. So either you are super motivated, have been super motivated, or you are very emotional. Because there's something you need to heal. Obviously, now that this full moon is in Virgo, you know, Virgo is the sign that comes in with the energy of being very critical about yourself or about your projects, about relationships, about many things in your life. Critical about other people. Again, try not to be too critical. When it comes to other people. And, you know, this can be unknown. Like, what do you call that? Unknowingly. Like, you unknowingly have a critical attitude when it comes to other people. Hello, Waylon. Everyone say hello, Waylon, to our neighbor's rooster. We named the rooster, if you didn't already know. But obviously, this full moon also, you know, rings the beginning of the spring. So again, we all want to clean out things. We all want to do new things. it is actually a pretty powerful magical new moon, full moon. I don't know why I want to say new moon all the time. And again, the retrograde journey is also ending. I actually think that I'm going to do it this way, that I'm going to go through all the signs and, you know, do some channeled messages, obviously using the cards, but also if I get something, you know, intuitively, you guys know how I work with that. One thing I want to say before, always check your sun sign and your moon sign, but especially check out your rising sign, because the rising sign actually tends to really be the cherry on the top when it comes to what's happening in your life at the moment. So maybe we should just start out with Virgo. So we start out with Earth now that this full moon is in an Earth sign. So Virgo, I mean, definitely, you know, a lot of you guys are being critical about yourself, or you're being critical about a project that you are working on. We have the Devil and we have the Star. So, hello Waylon. Maybe Waylon is a Capricorn. But we have Capricorn energy, we have Aquarius energy here. But definitely being, you know, hard on yourself. But also feeling, you know, your feet tap, like feeling that your desire inside of you is burning, feeling that, you know, this like action. Like you can feel deep inside of you that you want to move into something new now. You need to follow your dreams and desires because you do have the Star. Also, don't let anything hold you anymore. Don't let anyone stop you. Whatever it is that you want to achieve right now, I mean, with the Star, this is a huge congratulations for you. I am actually going to take another deck because then we can get more, you know, information. Taking off the blanket, rolling out of the frame. Alright, I'm back. Taking my blanket on again. So now that I did like an unboxing of this deck, I'm going to use it because it is a very powerful deck. So let's see what we can get for you Virgos. But you are moving into something new, so you don't, you know, you don't have anything to fear. I was looking at this card before. You are stepping into something completely new. Even though you might not feel that way, you are. Like, and this is, you know, this is the beginning of something new, so hello here. I do really feel that a lot of you guys are, you know, very emotional because you are going deep, you are healing something that kept you stuck in the past. There's a lot of heart healing because there's a lot of green in this. There's even something hidden because that you can see. There's this kind of staff or something like that in the shadow. So you are being fully guided into something new, into, you know, to step into your new power. Your dreams and desires are being prepared for you, but you do need to let go of, you know, this doubt that you have inside of you. Because you are longing, you know, you are longing for the new, you are longing for adventure. You are stepping into something completely new now. And it's also for you to be proud of who you are, who you became as a person. Again, you have nothing to fear when it comes to your future. The only thing that's standing in your way is actually yourself. That you're not believing, you know, in yourself. So let's continue with Taurus. Let's see what we can get for you, Taurus. I feel that for you, it's like the sun is shining again. Like, new things suddenly, you know, got presented to you. And we do have the Daughter of Pentacles. I mean, look at the rainbow. Like, you saw the end of the rainbow, you know, like in a good or in a, you know, positive way. Like you are on a new journey. You might feel like a deer in the headlights, like this is like a little scary because there's so many new things happening around you. Like you are a little baby deer stepping into a new world. A new world that you have been in for a long time, but still something brand new is happening in your life now. A lot of things are happening for you behind the scenes. Like you are being prepared. It might not be the time for you to step into the spotlight yet, because everything is so new right now. And that's something that you need to accept, that patient is something that you need in this time. And that is what this full moon is teaching you. You might be, you know, very shy, but you are very hardworking, and you do need to be proud of who you have become now. Let's see what we can get for you with daughter deck. Taurus. But you are like a newborn little deer. Hardworking newborn little deer. With a lot of patience. I do feel that it is, you know, it is easier for you. You do have taming the wind. So again, taming the storm inside of your mind, taming the... Again, if we are in the middle of a storm, we can't think clearly. We can't, you know, again, everything is just blowing away. So I do feel that you are at a point in time where everything is very quiet, but it's in a good way. I do feel it would be very good for you to write your thoughts down in a journey, write your ideas down, whatever comes to your mind, because again, the storm is quiet around you right now. So, you know, your ideas can, you know, come to you easier. And it's also for you to realize that the hard work is paying off now. I will also say that with this this full moon, do some meditation again together with your journal, and do some, you know, white sage or something so that you can cleanse off the old energy, because something major is going to happen for you with this full moon, but you do need to have patience with yourself. Let's take Capricorn. So what can we get for Capricorn with this full moon? Ooh, that was a jumper. The Father of Wands. We have a cobra, I believe it is. You really have the power of creativity around you with this full moon. And I heard that it's a blessing. So whatever is happening around you with this full moon, whatever creativeness, you know, is going to come out is a blessing for you. It's like a flash of sudden ideas or sudden impulsive need to... I don't know why I feel some of you guys are going to clean up a closet or clean up something, and you're going to find something that's going to pique your creativity, as some kind of idea is going to come from that. You might even be someone who is supposed to be a healer. If you feel that you have conflicts in your life, try to, you know, kill it with kindness, with compassion, because that is what you need at this time. Also for you, let's see what we can get. We have the Vision Quest. Yeah, look at this. She's just dancing out there, dancing away, becoming her higher self. I do feel that you might even be someone who, you know, will take walks in the forest or in the nature today. If not, it might be something that you might need to do, because that the clarity that you are seeking is something that's going to come your way. It is linked together with, I do feel it's linked together with a nature spirit that's going to help you. It might be a new spirit that's even going to follow you. It's going to help you with clarity. Clarity when it comes to your creativity. clarity when it comes to a person, maybe. Maybe even a fire sign. Now that we had the Father of Wands, it can even be clarity about a father figure. Doesn't have to be your father, but it can be someone who's a father of your child, or, you know, you might be the father of a child, that there's some kind of clarity that's going to come. But for you, it's important to get off the couch, go out in nature, because a new spirit is waiting for you. A good spirit, like a guide, like a spirit guide. Let's take Libra. I am also Libra, so, you know, this is going to be interesting. So let's see, Libra. What is the magical things for Libra? First of all, I do have this feeling of you need to get out of your head. Yeah. You do need to get out of your head. Because you do have the Nine of Swords. You might walk around with a lot of dark thoughts. And it, again, it might not be something that you do purposely. It might be because that you have taken on a lot of energy from other people. That's something you do really need to clean out with this full moon. I do also feel that for you, Libra, there is a lot of hidden truth that you will be ready to take out and analyze. There's a lot of truth around other people that's going to come out. I do feel that you are really going to do some shadow work. Even if you are ready for it or not, shadow work is something that you are going to do. It might even be something that you have started out doing the past month. Maybe you have even started out since January doing, you know, shadow work. I feel some of you guys have been journaling about shadow work, or you have been journaling about depression or this anxious feeling that you have been in. And it is, you know, a therapy. Some of you guys might have had nightmares. That's also a therapy. Everything that's dark that has been around you or that is around you right now is something you need to go through, because it's healing. Like dreaming about that your parents die, or dreaming about that someone dies, that you kill someone, whatever. It is because that it has a deeper meaning. So if you have dreams, try to Google them, because again, if you dream about dying or killing someone, it's never about that. I don't know why I feel some of you guys have had a dream about a swan, maybe a black swan. There's something about a swan. Whatever happens in your life, it's like the monsters on their bed. It's representing guilt, failures, fears, despair, even depression. I do feel like you guys are healing depression with this moon. Let's take the other deck. Already have one for you. The Ancient Ones. Spirit guides are presenting themselves for you. I did talk about that because I have a new spirit guide, which is a white tiger. And his name is Oksam. And he really, you know, it was after, because I had a very vivid dream about that my father died. And that was, I mean, that was the most scary thing. I did talk a tiny bit about it, because that was, he was actually, you know, here when it happened, because I woke up and, you know, I was telling her about a dream, and I realized that it's a fear inside of me that I needed to release or work with, you know, heal. There's a new destiny waiting for you, Libra. A very huge destiny. Like, you have a huge destiny in front of you. Some of you, I don't know why I feel some of you guys are afraid of dying. You are afraid of not having time. There is a new, either this is someone, an ancestor who passed over, or this is a new spirit guide who's coming into your life to heal that, or to take the steps with you so that you can heal this. Because this is dark fear. This is dark fear linked together from a past life. So, you are healing big time. Alright, Gemini. Let's see what... I'm totally cuddling with my blanket. So, a lot of thoughts I heard. A lot of, Well, we have, there's a lot of daughters and fathers and sons with today's readings. We have the Daughter of Swords. So, you know, air sign. A lot of things going on in your life right now. A lot of wisdom coming to you with this moon. I do feel that you're being honest, you know, to yourself about what it is that you actually want. I feel that you guys are healing depression, seasonal depression. I do feel you're a little observer these days, like you observe people or you observe situations. Like you really look into situations or you really look at people. I don't know why I have this feeling, like you have this feeling like you analyze people very closely. Just, you know, gosh, it freaks me out every time it does that. But to find out, like, something's wrong. Or, like, maybe even, you know, trying to use your gifts, like your intuitiveness, your powers. Others of you might even feel like you have someone who's looking over your shoulder all the time, or someone who's like, you know, always having an eye on you, and that might also be something that you, you know, that stops you a little bit. Like, there is a burden when it comes to always having the feeling of having one eye open, or feeling that, you know, that people always look very close at what you do, how you act. Maybe as a mother, I don't know why I feel that. Maybe you have a mother who is overbearing. Let's see what we have for you. When I did the unboxing, this card scares me for some reason, because I don't know, there's something with these eyes. Let me know if it's just me, but they are very human-like. It's almost scary. This card scares me. But, you know, again, it is Earth. It's so, I do feel that you will be very linked together with this full moon. I don't know why I feel that some of you guys might even be dealing with a Virgo or Earth sign. But it makes sense, or because it has this, like, looking. Like, you feel that someone is watching over you. This can be negative, but this can also be positive. Maybe some of you guys have had signs with owls. Like, you hear them, you see them. I do feel that you are also being watched over. Always being watched over. Like, you know, don't fear anything, because you are very protected. I do feel that you need to look at your natural gifts, like, you know, your ability to manifest, or your ability to see people for how they really are. I do feel that is something you need to, you know, really pay attention to with this moon. I just need to take my Pepsi. I got this from a customer. Thank you, Annette. Oh, damn. All right, Aquarius. Aquarius, Aquarius, Aquarius. I don't know why I heard you are very mysterious. Like, someone feels, you're dealing with someone who feels that you are very mysterious. Someone who, you know, like, you have someone around you who really don't know how to handle you, or who don't know, like, I don't know why I have this feeling, like, what is it that you want? Like, there's something mysterious about you. It can also be you having this feeling about someone else. Let's see what we can get for you, Aquarius. You are mysterious. The Wheel of Fortune, tangling up, out. All the loose ends, finding out where all the colors belong. Red to red, blue to blue. I do feel that you are trying to do things in a new way now. Maybe some of you guys are changing jobs, or you want to change job, or you want to do something new in your life, and you're trying to make all the things, you know, fall into place. And it will, now that you have the Wheel of Fortune. Again, if you feel stuck, it's only temporary. Because change is coming big time. for you the next month ahead, especially with this full moon. I do feel that you have the power to really find out, you know, it's like if you try to tangle out a necklace or something, there's one piece that makes it all very complicated, and you find out what that thing is. And I do feel that destiny and faith has a very large, wow, Waylon is just out there today. Destiny and faith have a very big role in your life at this moment, with whatever, you know, whatever direction the wheel is turning or whatever happens in your life, if destiny is really a big part of it. I even feel that for some of you guys, your life will take a new turn. Like, you can't be sure that everything goes in the direction that you think. Like, you need to let destiny play out what destiny wants to play out at this moment. You have the witness. Yeah. Things are moving in the faith, or, you know, in direction that's supposed to move right now. I also feel that some of you guys maybe lost a pet that's actually guiding you right now. I do also feel that, what, you know, I was just about to say whatever it is. If this is a pet, or if this is someone who's crossed over, or if this is someone who's passed over, it's someone who's there to open your third eye. It's like the last journey for you. There's something that's the last that you need to figure out so that you can move in the direction that you want to move in. It's like something that's been with you all along, like a spirit guide or something, like even your higher self, is ready to step into the light now, which is pretty beautiful. So, you know, whatever needs to be tangled out, let it be tangled out. So let's take fire. I just had the hermit here, so some of you guys might be dealing with a Virgo. Very fitting for the full moon, but it can also just be, you know, that you need to get out of your shell now with this new moon or full moon. But hello, Sagittarius. I was like, who am I on? Let's say Sagittarius, because I said that. Wow, Three of Cups. Something to celebrate. I do really feel that, you know, I have this feeling of a newborn. Like, a lot of flowers, a lot of yellow, a lot of, like, a lot of orange, a lot of happiness, a lot of harmony. You are going to find new friends. You're going to be in the company of old friends. You're really going to have a lot of happiness and a lot of stability in your life right now. If you feel lonely, new friends will, you know, be presented for you. I do feel that you are being connected with a lot of, you know, trustworthy, important people who are going to guide you in the direction of what it is that you want to do now. Let's take more. This keeps falling down. So let's see what else we can get for Sagittarius. Lovely energy. I heard someone say lovely energy in a, like a British or maybe Scottish accent. Ugh, the holy mountain. Someone is going to guide you up to that mountain. If you guys remember, I did speak about the mountain, like that the ego is down in the valley and our higher self is at the top of the mountain, and you need to get up there. But the ego is like, I can't because it's far away and it's hard. Someone very exciting is being guided in your direction now. Wow. For some of you guys, this is a soulmate. For others of you, it's, you know, I mean, friends can also be soulmates, but this can also be involving love. But you're going to rise. You're going to reach what you have been looking for the longest time. Congratulations. Then let's take Aries. The need to move, Aries, the need to move, the need to show your true colors. We have the Mother of Swords. Do you have a female who's there to help you, maybe. I do feel that for some of you guys, you have a female who said something to you. Maybe someone you had a conversation with, who tried to steer you in your new direction, in a maybe more mysterious direction. But you don't believe or trust yourself. You don't, yeah. You don't feel that you have the wisdom that you need to follow the new path. Maybe this female, you know, didn't appear yet. I feel for some of you guys, this female didn't appear yet. I do feel that some of you guys maybe even started therapy. But there's someone who's going to help you with whatever you struggle with at the moment. Let's also take another card for you. So a special person is going to come into your life. It is a female. I do strongly feel for you guys that this is a female who's going to help you. Flow. Someone is going to help you. Someone is going to help you guide your flow, your emotions, get control over your emotions. Some of you guys are going to get out of medicine. You're going to, again, you're going to find a new way how to bloom up and get, you know, I do feel like you guys might be very, very stuck in your life at the moment. And someone is going to come into your life and take the emotions out of you and really like form them to something healing. It is a very, very powerful transformation that you're going through. Healing transformation. Beautiful transformation. I do also feel that for you, the female can even be your higher self. Doesn't have to be a physical person. But it's a sign that you're in, you know, your intuition is being set in motion again. So you have to trust your intuition. Like, you know, the mother owl comes with its knowledge to you in dreams or however with your gut feelings. And you need to analyze and be open for the message. It's also for you to dare to move in a direction that you might feel hard. Whatever it is that you're struggling with, you are strong enough. I do feel that it has this energy that be proud of how far you came, because you came a long way. You know, pay attention to this person coming into your life, or again, maybe it is your higher self. We have Leo, so let's see Leo. Oh, wow. The Magician, you are manifesting what it is that you want now. And the beautiful thing is with the Magician is that he does have all the tools. This is, you know, number one. It's actually number two because the first card is the Fool. And I did speak about this in the past with the Fool is taking the leap of faith and making the choice to go in the direction of where the Fool wants to go. And the Magician is the Fool because the Fool made the choice to move in the direction of his dreams. That means that the universe provided all the tools. You made the decision. So if you recently made a decision for something, something creative, you made a wise choice. For you, I do feel that your stillness of mind, like your mentality has been very quiet. Like, you know, maybe that's what you need, but it really helped you because you already took the steps that you needed to take. Or maybe you have been thinking about, like, I want to choose a new job. Some of you guys are letting go of a person. But I do also feel that you are becoming stronger, like... If you have had any person in your life who's been tricky, you're not going to let anyone be tricky anymore. Also with your mind, because the mind can be very tricky sometimes. But you are so much more powerful to walk in the direction of where you actually want now. So you can be proud of that. But if there is a sneaky person, if there is a trickster, because again, the Magician can be a trickster, pay attention to that. But again, you have the tools to see what this person wants. So let's take Scorpio. So let's see, Scorpio, what can we get for you? Okay. Wow. Daughter of Wands. It's funny that we have a lot of daughters, we have a lot of sons, we have a lot of fathers and mothers in this reading today. So a lot of you guys being guided very heavily. Look at this magic. You are blooming, Scorpio. I do feel that you are, you know. Also, because in this deck, I feel that this card is very magic oriented. So, why are we blurry? Hello? So, a lot of you guys are being guided in, you know, to do witchcraft or to do pagan or Reiki healing. Or, you know, there's some kind of new magic that you're being guided into, like you are blooming. You have, it is creative because it is wand, so it's linked together with your creativity. It's linked together with what it is that you want, maybe even working with flowers or herbs. You are a free spirit and you should be very proud of who you are, because you are free. You can make the decisions that you want. Some of you guys are going to change your religion, or it has a feeling that something has been weighing down, or someone has weighed you down. Someone maybe really put, I don't know why I want to say demons in your head, like you can't do this because that's, you know, then that is going to happen. You're going to do your own thing now. You are a free spirit. You're going to be very busy with your career, let me tell you. No time for family right now. I do feel that for a lot of you guys, I mean, you might have family, but I do feel that you're going to be very busy when it comes to a new project. You know, don't settle down. I do feel that is a major one for you. Don't settle down. And don't let anyone tell you what you should do, because you are, again, a free spirit. Okay, this one. Upper world. I had a feeling that a lot of you guys are connecting with a new whole entire world. New spirit guides, new goddess, gods. You are being guided because that you are ready. Because that you are freeing yourself from something from the past. You can be very proud of this. So many new things are going to happen for you now. And you are You are connected on a very spiritual level, a deep spiritual level. I mean, you are Scorpio, so of course you are. This is a time for you to realize that you need to step into your higher self, to who you are. For some of you, it's very important that you step into who you want to become. Not to hide anymore. Something might have happened, or, you know, something happened in the past year that made you... I just got spirit chills, so yeah, that made you very fearful for becoming who you actually want to become. It's time for you to rise, I always want to say raise with the wind. Whatever you see as a problem or obstacle is actually irrelevant, it's not a problem, because again, you are a free spirit. So Scorpio, free spirit. Then let's take Pisces, because we don't want you to be the last one all the time. Whoa! Six of Pentacles. But it's a beautiful Six of Pentacles. This is a new Six of Pentacles. You're going through a lot of growth. But the darkness is behind you. Whatever you have feared is behind you. And, you know, your long-awaited rewards are finally starting to, you know, pay out. Like, whatever you have been waiting for and working very hard on the past year is finally becoming ready. I do feel that this is harvest time for you with this full moon. Harvest time. If you have been struggling with money, you don't need to struggle anymore, because that is for sure going to come your way. Expected, unexpected. I do feel it has this energy of expect the unexpected, but let it come to you naturally, like a tree. Like, again, we know that a tree is going to bloom. Like, we don't have to sit next to the tree and wait for it. You know it's going to happen. I do feel someone is going to be very, you know, generous with you. Someone is going to share and give something to you. This can be materialistic, but this can also be an idea that's going to help you. Let's see what else we can get for you. The Heart of Sky. I mean, oh my God, guys. You all get the most beautiful cards now. You scare me all the time. This is a reminder for you that you are the original channel, you know, from the universe, from the magic within you. Like, you have deep magic to manifest. I do feel that you are a manifester. Also, you are Pisces, so you are very spiritual. You are the original manifester. I don't know what to call that. You know, to be proud of yourself, because you are very spiritual. You have the power to connect with the universe, to, you know, cosmic beings. I don't know why I want to say that. You need to become the paintbrush now, because again, your fruit is ready, your paint is ready, your creation is ready. So enjoy this connection that you have. Enjoy it, Pisces. Then we have the last one, and that is Cancer. We have a card that's sticking up, so I think we should take it. Of course we should take this, because this is the High Priestess. Hello, Cancer. You are becoming the wise person in your life, your own life, making your own decisions, being very intuitive. I do feel that you are very calm when it comes to your intuition, especially with this full moon. This is the power of, you know, mysteries, psychic abilities, obviously intuition. I do feel that it's also here because you need to pay more close attention to the voice inside of you. Like, also your gut feeling, like you are steering in the right direction. Wild woman. Yeah. I mean, look at this. Okay, camera died. Camera died. What is up with you, camera? If you have been stuck sitting inside, not trusting that anything is happening, you know, this is a sign. All right, Rooster. This is a sign that you need to get out now, because your intuition is so sharp and spot on that you need to get out there and follow your dreams. Like, you are ready. I do feel a lot of you guys have been, you know, it's like sitting on a gold mine, like just waiting for something to happen so that you could get out there and shine your light. Now is your time. So some of you guys are, you know, going to become tarot readers. Some of you guys, I don't know why I feel like you want to make money with doing tarot, but you have, you know, yeah. You never had the courage to take the jump. You need to go out there and take the jump. Your long-awaited dream is finally starting, you know, to spring up. Like, the creation of what it is that you have been waiting for is ready. So with this magical full moon, you do need to go out there, create, do whatever it is that you want, because the High Priestess is with you. Again, for some of you guys, you also have new spirit guides. Again, there's a lot of new spirit guides for people. It is because that we're stepping up in the game. Like, we are not meant to sit that, you know, alone anymore. We're not meant to not do anything. So listen to your intuition, because there is a loud and clear message waiting for you, and I do feel that you already have an idea of what this is. But this is going to be everything for this magical full moon reading. I hope you guys are going to enjoy this full moon. Again, go out there, be strong and amazing, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye.